Hey everybody, High Lord Tamburlaine back with more obscurities in miniature. Today we've got an adjunct model. Oh, it's interesting. This is the Morphling, and the Morphling is another of the Gibbering Hordes models. That's why you have this bug-eyed fish monster here for Wyrd's new mass combat game, The Other Side. So I'm assuming that's what's going to be in the box. A gross chest burster, back burster monster popping out of this dude. I think this is a barbed skulker, whereas that is a striped skulker. Why I know that, I don't know. But I also know that, oh, there, I'm having a hard time opening the box. Let's see what's inside. And as always, we're joined by our intrepid usual cast of various model. Oh, there's a couple of them. That's interesting, because last time I popped one of these boxes open, there was a single model, and I get a nice bent card packed with bases. That's weird. I don't know what size bases have. That's a 40mm base. Okay. So, as I talk to myself and have nothing on camera, why don't we rectify that situation? So, this is a Morphling, and you can see what they're supposed to be doing is switching from one type of unit to the other. Maybe it's a Urazi, which is one of the other units, but that is absolutely definitely a barbed skulker. You can see he's transforming. I think the idea behind these guys is if you have them on these fire team bases, you can actually replace one of the members of the unit with one of these things, and somehow they swap out or switch things later on. I do think you can actually use an adjunct model with just about every faction. I think every faction's got one, or at least they will soon enough. So, how does he stack up with regular humans? Well, I probably should put him on a base and get my fingers out of the way and put him in focus and stop playing with the zoom lens, but you know what? Sorry, it is what it is. So that's not actually a base, it's a 40mm base, and I don't want to fight with trying to get that open. Let's get them closer so we can take a better look. I had heard an interesting idea of taking some of these Gibbering Hordes monsters and actually using them for games of Shadows of Brimstone, so that's why I'm including one of our Brimstone figures there. But they are pretty comparable in size, at least our Morphling is, to a Through the Breach, not Through the Breach, The Other Side model, or any of the Malifaux stuff on the table. So, ignore the humans for a moment. Let's see how they stack up with some of the other models from the Gibbering Hordes. So here's one of the armored whelks, which obviously is a lot bigger. Or we can grab one of the striped skulkers. This is, I believe, what's supposed to be coming out of him, or one of the Urazi, which I do have a box of somewhere. I don't remember where I put them, actually. So you can see they have quite long tails. Or we have the Frenzy as well, which is one of the commander units. It's actually a unit of commanders, I should say. They're a lot larger. I don't have my Horomatangi handy because I started painting him, but I do have a Carcanoi as well, which is another of the mainstay units that Gibbering Hordes are using. So you can see here you have a faction of literally nothing but aquatic-based monsters. So if you are interested in any kind of crazy, scaly, multi-legged creature, I mean, this is an awesome faction that you probably can get a lot of use out of. And the fact that you get three of these guys versus one, you know, I did a video on one of these before, the Breachling. You only get one of these, whereas in this box you get three. Where'd the third one go? You're hiding there. Hallelujah! And they're cheering on their friend here since he's got three mouths. Maybe they're going to feed all the mouths. I don't know. But they are neat little models, and this is going to be an interesting one to paint. Do you want to try to have completely clashing colors as the one erupts from the other, and I can't get it in focus. Come on, man. There we go. And it bears repeating that the details on the figures for the other side, despite being this kind of bendy, board gamey plastic, there is a lot of detail there, but on the other hand, you're going to have a lot of cleanup if you're really up there in terms of painting. You know, you can see all the little barbed spikes on his underbelly there, which is kind of cool. I'm actually looking forward to seeing those striped skulkers come out. No, barbed. I have the striped ones. Darn it, I keep confusing them. All right, looking at his hands, I actually think that's one of the flying Urazi things, but who knows? Anyway, Interesting little model for $10 to get three of them. They're all in 40mm bases. They're all decently sized, and they fit in quite well with the rest of their nasty-looking posse, which are significantly bigger than most of the humans on the table. They're definitely going to give a human model a good run for its money. So like I said, somebody came up with an interesting idea of trying to eventually make these into a whole deck of adversaries for Shadows of Brimstone for some kind of underwater ruin lair. That might be kind of neat. You could probably use them in just about any kind of fantasy game. There's nothing techie about them. They're just neat monster models. And after all, that's one of the reasons I'm so into the tabletop stuff. It's just cool looking monsters. So, I'll leave you guys with that. Again, this is High Lord Tamberlane with Obscurities and Miniatures saying thanks for watching. See you later. Bye-bye.